An amazing Let's go. an aunt who lives not far from here. Out, in the woods, outside of Athens. If we can but escape to her cottage, then she can hide us. Once hidden, then we can find a priest who will marry us. Then not even Lord Theseus can harm us, for no man has the power to break the sacred bonds of marriage. Tonight, you must escape from your father's house and meet me in the forest.
My love, I will.
But hush, my dears, for here comes Helena, who may give away our plot.
Don't speak for Helena. Where dost thou?
Call you me fair? Ha! It is Demetrius loves you, not me. It is you he thinks us fair, not me. I am miserable.
But I do not love him. I scorn him.
It matters not. It is you he loves. Me, he thinks I'm a toad.
Take comfort. He no longer shall see my face. He is yours to have with your grace.
And to Hana, to you our plan we will unfold. Tonight, under the full moon, we two shall escape into the woods and pledge our love and be married.
Therefore, Demetrius will be yours alone. Keep our secret, dear friends. Now come, my love. We must go to speak to my father and pretend to them that you accepted their will of free. For by seeming to give consent, my father will give you the freedom that will allow me to flee from this house tonight. Adieu.
Never fear. Your secret is safe with me. Oh, spite and spite and terrible spite. It was I Demetrius loved until he met Hermia. I was the sweetest. I was the fairest. But now all I can see is she. Oh, unfair love, why are you always so blind? But wait, if I pick Demetrius to see, how Hermia despises him and how she dotes on Lysander, maybe he can come back to me. I'll tell him of the lover's plan, and he'll follow them, and I'll follow him. Then he'll see how she acts in turning from her. He'll find me true.
Is all I can be. Call them according to their roles in the script.
Here is the name of every person thought fit to play in or to before the Duke, on his wedding day, at night.
First, give us the name of the play, and then call the actors.
Mary, our play is called The Most Lamentable Comedy of Cruel Death of Pyramus and Reason. Not for the actors, make bottom believe it.
Ready, what part do I have?
Shall play Pyramus.
What is Pyramus? A lover or a villain?
A lover that kills himself most beautifully for love.
Oh, that will call for tears. I will create in the audience a flood of tears, a storm of tears, a delusion of tears. Noah shall build another ark for the tears that these eyes will shed. A veritable river of tears, a sea of tears, an ocean of tears. That was pretty good.
Would the bellows be good?
You okay, Bruce?
You should play Thisbe.
What is Thisbe, but for you tonight?
It is the lady that Pyramus must love.
Oh, don't make me play it, Paul.
You can play it in a mask and in a tune of voice.
I could play Thisbe too. I was given the tiniest of the boys. Thisbe, Thisbe. Oh, here it is, love you!
No. You must play here.
And Flute, you play Dizzy.
Oh well, proceed.
Robin Starling and Taylor?
Here, Peter Prince.
You? Here, Mrs. Buckley. Myself? Dizzy's Buckley. Snow the Joiner, you the line clerk. And that's the cast.
Have you the lines for ring? Pray, if it's written, give it to me for our slow study.
It's only worry.
I can play the line too. I will roar, simple two men good to hear me. Roar! I will roar, since I will make the Duke say. Let him roar again! Oh, let him roar again!
If you roar too terribly and frighten the ladies, the Duke will hang us.
Hang us!
That's true. But I can roar gently. Roar! And they say I'm in the sweet lion.
You can play no part but pyramids. For pyramids is the most important part of the play.
Then by all means, I am for pyramids. And for the other ones, we shall just have to make do.
Good. That's it. It'll do us no good to rehearse in the town, for everyone shall know and thereby spoil the surprise. Let us begin the forest tonight and make a practice of our parts, so that all will say, what clever fellows you have performed so brilliantly with such quicks. Perhaps, too, the Duke shall make us some reward for our goodly entertainments.
And now, we can do fairies.
How now, spirits? Whither wander thou?
Over hill? Over dale, through brush, through briar. From part of the tales to flood his side.
We do honor everywhere, swifter than the moon's cheer.
And we serve the fair queen to do her orbs upon the green.
Be careful that your fairy queen does not come here tonight. My master, the fairy king Oberon, is angry with her, for she stole away a child that he wished to make his own. If she does not give the child back, my master will do something terrible.
If your master is Oberon, then you must be that mischievous rascal, Robin Goodfellow.
'Tis true, and others call me Puck. My master's slave am I, and do his bidding to perform all sorts of devilment. But stand aside, here comes my master now.
And here comes our mistress, the fairy queen, Titania.
Proud queen, have you come to beg forgiveness of me?
Jealous Oberon, I need nothing from you. Quick fairies, let us leave this place.
Wait, rash Titania, am I not your husband?
Husband, yes, but master, no, I am not your slave.
Give me the child which you've stolen. I would have him for my own, raise him to the manliest of arts, to hunt wild game, to raise lance and shield.
You would raise him to war and killing. I will have none of that. No, we shall sing sweet songs and dance. He shall bring me flowers and play with my sweet elves.
A wife who loves obeys her husband.
Then methinks I love you not at all. Fairies away.
Poppy, come here. Go around the world and fetch the flower which is called the flower of love. Whomsoever its juice does touch falls in love with which their eyes first see. I think it's time I taught that erring wife of mine a lesson.
I hear my master and obey.
But who comes here? I have become invisible and attend.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not. Where am I sent there, Maria? You swore to me that they would be here. When I catch them, I shall slay that dog Lysander.
I love you so.
Why? Don't I tell you that I don't love you?
And even so, I love you all the more.
I become sick when I look on you.
I become sick when I
I run from thee and hide in these woods.
Run where you will and hide. My love will always find you.
Fare thee well, man. It seems you could use some help from me, and you shall have it. Before this night is out, your Demetrius shall love only you. Hast thou the flower yet?
Yes, here is it.
Give it to me. I will go to where Titania takes her sleep and put its juice upon her eyes,
so that when she wakes, she will fall in love with what she first sees. You take some of this slow potion, and in the wood you will find a sweet, appealing lady. She loves a young man, but he loves her not. Put some of this in his eyes while he sleeps, so that when he too wakes, he will fall in love with her instantly.
Your servants so shall do.
We are both so tired and to be truthful, I am lost. Perhaps we shall sleep here, and the light will find our way to my aunt's cottage.
Sweetest bystander, you are right. You lie there and you lie here, and these mossy banks will be our pillows. Sleep well, my gentle love.
Through the forest have I gone, but Athenian I've found none. Here, he's dressed like a Athenian. This must be the boy of whom my master spoke. And look over here, the very maiden that he scorns. You wretch, you beast, how can you be so cruel to such a pretty maid? In your eyes I'll put this potion so that you might get it and make this maiden happy. Now I'll away to Oberon.
I love you so.
Please, 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 leave me alone.
Will you leave me? Do I go?
I go and go and go. Pray, heaven, woman, leave me alone.
It's Helena that I love. How could I ever think to love you?
You?
You are one ugly woman. Wait, Helena, wait. Here comes your sweetest Lysander. Helena, oh, Helena.
Help, help, Lysander. Oh, what an awful dream. I dreamt I was a toad. Lysander, where is he? Oh, maybe he was drunk off by some type of beast. Don't worry, my love. I'll find you. Lysander, oh, Lysander.
Undoubtedly, you've been wondering how all this corruption could have gone on without breaking my table. I mean, I don't play. Shakespeare did, and so I'm calling a professor about it. But I do have a note here, and it says that he is not thinking it was an inquisitive invention when the audience would have understood. Okay, how about nobody seeing her life right here on stage? The audience understood that theory were always invisible to mere mortals, and that's enough explanation. Yet you won't look at the show.
Oh, we're not here. Yes.
This appears an excellent spot for it. Let's go.
Peter Quiz.
Yes.
The script says here that in this comedy of Pyramus and his team, Pyramus must draw his sword and kill himself. That will never do. It will scare the ladies and make them cry.
Yes, we must leave the killing out.
Not so late. I have a plan. Write a prologue for this play which tells the ladies that we will do them no harm. They are only plague swords, and that Pyramus doesn't really kill. Better yet, write to that I am not afraid of Pyramus, but only Bob, the weaver.
Won't the ladies be afraid of the lion?
Yes, yes. So, write this as well. He is only snug, the joiner. And what part of his face be shown, and write ladies, or fair ladies. I would wish you, or I would request you. I would entreat you to fear not, no, to tremble not.
So shall I write. But here's two problems of which we have not left. One is moonlight for appearance of Bisbee meets a moonlight.
A man must enter with a lantern and say that he comes to present the person of moonshine.
All right. There's one other thing. We must have a wall in the plate of Pyramus and Thisbe, says Thoric. The top very cheek in the wall.
We can't bring in a wall.
Some man must present a wall. And let him have upon him a piece of plaster to signify a wall. And let him hold his fingers thus. Through the screen, shall Pyramus and Thisbe whisper.
And on the book. And now, let's do the verse. What a bunch of homespun bumpkins. How we here and so near our very pretty resting place. What? A play? I'll listen and may chance become an actor myself.
Speak, Pyramus. This is my court.
Thisbe, the flower of odors, say the sweet.
Odors. Odors.
Odors, say the sweet. But hark a voice, stand thou in here a while, and by, to thee I shall appear.
A stranger, Pyramus, shall reappear.
Must I speak now?
Aye, you must.
Most radiant, Pyramus, most wonderful by you. Meet thee, and Ninny's tomb.
Ninny's tomb, you ninny. Now, keep Pyramus to return. The key was never tired.
That's true. So, as yet, we're never tired.
If I were a bird this week, I would only die.
Oh, monstrous. Oh, strange. Mirror haunted. Rhinoceros, bulldozers, help!
I'll follow you. I'll lead you round about. Through bog, through bush, through brake, through briar. Sometimes a horse I'll be, sometimes a hound. A hog, a headless bear. But you I'll scare and scare and scare.
Why do you run away?
Oh, Bottom, thou art has changed. What do I see?
What do you see? You are an ass!
No. No, Bottom, to see who is the ass.
Bless thee, Bottom. Bless thee, that art haunted, that art bewitched.
I know what you're up to. This is some great joke. They are trying to frighten me. Well, they can't fool me. I'll stand in the spot and never move. I'll show them that they can't make an ass out of me. Who's that at the top of his bottom? It's Peter! Who is always the best? It's Bottom. It's Peter!
What angel wakes me from my sleep?
Bottom cannot see Titanium clear because he's enchanted.
I pray you, just mortal, sing again. I love your singing, and I am here to say I do believe I love thee.
Methinks, mistress, you have little reason to love me. I must go and take my prize.
Out of this wood, do not desire to go. I do love thee, and will give thee fairies to serve thee. Peepos, Kama, Moth, and Mustard Seed.
Ready.
Kiss me, I'm gonna see you alone.
Oh, this is an awful joke! Now you all
of Hermia, leave me, beautiful Helena.
Hermia's a toad. It's Helena that I love and shall until I die. Look, here comes Hermia. You take it, Lysander.
Oh, Lysander, I finally found you. I heard your voice from the forest and I followed here. Why did you leave?
Love made me go.
Why should you love me so much that you would leave me?
Love for Helena and hate for you made me go.
Are you out of your mind? It's me.
Let go of me, you toad, you cat. Come, Helena.
Touch her not. She's mine.
I'll fight you for her.
Then come, let's have this done. We'll fight and one of us shall die. But he who lives shall wed fair Helena.
Thank you. Thank you.
Undoubtedly, this play would have been called As the Midsummer's Night Dream Turns, or The Edge of My Midsummer's Night Dreams, or All of My Midsummer's Night Dreams.
Get your weapons in hand and kill me a wretch of honeybee, and bring me this bag of honey. Where is Mustard Seed?
Here.
Give me your hand, good Mustard.
What is your pleasure, sir?
Nothing but to help Peas Blossom scratch. I must go to the barber's, methinks, for I think I model this area about my head, and crude fellow that I have never not scratched when I need to in public, thereby making an ass out of myself.
Wilt thou hear some music, my sweet love?
I have a good ear for music.
Or say, sweet love, what thou desirest to eat?
I could surely munch some good dry oats, or better yet, a good bundle of hay. Good hay, sweet hay, hath no match.
I shall have some duchess and fairy fetch me some nuts.
Actually, I have a gobble of soap, handful or two of carrots. But I pray you, let none of your people stir me, for I feel sleep coming upon me.
Sleep thou, and I will wind thee in my arms. Fairies be gone. Oh, how I love thee, how I dote on thee.
So bewitched that when I asked her for the child of whom we quarreled, she gave him to me instantly. All she could think about was her loathsome beast. And now I will look for enchantment, and when I deal good luck, you take off the ass's head, so that when all returns to normal, all will think it was just a dream. A dream of love on an enchanted midsummer's night. Now to remove the enchantment. Be as thou wast wont to be, see as thou wast wont to see. Now, Titania, awake, my sweet queen.
My Oberon, what visions have I seen? Methought I was the mouth of an ass.
Here lies your love.
How came these things to pass?
Silence of life. Huck, remove his enchantment.
And then, when thou awakest with thine own fool's eyes, see.
Very king as Endenmark, I do hear the morning light.
Hit a foot. Flute. Snout. Starlet? Where are you?
It appears they left me in the forest where I slept. I had the most extraordinary dream. Not possible. But if I told anyone my dream, they'd think I was an ass. Perhaps I'll have the prince write a play about my dream. It shall be called Bottom's Dream. For it happened. Now, I must away to act. Methinks tonight is our time.
This man is breaking water, doth present wall.
that wild woe which did these lovers keep apart, and through woe's cheek poor souls they are content to whisper. This man with lantern presents moonshine for it to know. By moonshine that these lovers think to meet. This grisly beast which high by name, the trusty fist becoming first by night, did scare away, or rather, did affright. And as she fled her scarf, she did let fall, would lie in wild bloody mouth did stay. And then comes Pyramus, sweet youth and tall, and finds the lovely fisty scarf now slain. Wreathed with blade, with bloody playful blade, he bravely broached his boiling bloody breast, and this beat tearing a mulberry shape. His dagger drew and died. For all the rest, let lion, moonshine, wall, and lovers join. At large discourse, while here they do remain.
In the same interlude, it doth befall that I, once now by name, present a law. And this is the cranny right and sinister in which the fearful lovers are to whisper.
Do you need Brittany Mortar to speak?
In truth, my lord, it is the funniest wall I ever heard.
Silence! For here comes Pyramus.
Oh, friend looking knight, oh, knight with you so black. O knight, whatever art when day is not. O knight, alack, alack, alack. Fear my kiss, be as forgotten to meet me here. Thou wall, wall, sweet and lovely wall. Thou standest between her father's house and mine. Thou wall, wall, sweet and lovely wall. Show me thy cheek to blink with mine own eyes. Thanks, Turnus wall, but what see I? No, this be do I see. O wicked wall, through whom I see no bliss, cursed be thy stones for thus deceiving me.
Methinks the wall should curse him back.
No, in truth, sir, he should not. Deceiving me is this beast here. This beast to enter, and I am to see her through the wall. Yonder she comes.
Oh, what did thou scorn my mind? I miss my dearly song.
I see a voice. Now will I to the chief, to spy, and I can hear my thisby's face. Thisby!
My love, thou art my love, I think.
Think what thou wilt. I am my lover's grace. Kiss me through the hole of this vile wall.
I kiss the wall's hole, but not the lips at all.
Wilt thou at Minnie's too meet me tonight?
Through time and death, I come without delay.
Thus have I evolved. Heart discharged so, and being done thus, wall away will go.
This is the silliest stuff I have ever heard. You ladies, you whose gentle hearts do fear the smallest monstrous mouse that creeps on floor, may now perchance both quake and tremble here. Know me is snug, and I'll try to be the most gentle lion. A very gentle beast.
The very best.
Proceed, Moon.
All that I have to tell you is that this lantern doth seem to be, and this bush is a bush.
This is all that is true. Where is my love?
Roar!
Well, Lord Lion.
Well run, Fisby. Well shown, Moon. Well shown, Lion. Now, here comes Pyramus.
Sweet Moon, I thank thee for thy sunny beams. I hope to see my Thisby here. But what is this? Oh hell, oh spite, the scarf stained with blood. That vile lion hath killed my dear, which is, no, which was the fairest dear. Come, tears, out, sword, and wound the heart of Pyramus. Thus I die, thus. Now I am dead, now! Moon, take thy flight! Thus I die. Die.
I already.
Asleep, my lord? Look dead, my lord. Speak, speak. Are you dumb? Dead, dead? Oh, God, oh, God. Oh, Lord. Tell me, my lord. Come trust in God. Come right into my maiden's heart. And thus this be ends. Dead, 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 dead.
To see the epilogue?
No. Your play needs no epilogue. No play where everyone is dead needs an epilogue. Perhaps, a rustic dance will do your play. Good night.